Hello everyone. Printing various triangular patterns is a very important one both in your C programming syllabus and also for placements. There are various triangular patterns that can be printed. Some of them are simple, some of them are little complicated, and some of them are tricky. In this video, we shall see how to write program for printing these basic triangular formats, and there are various triangular formats which we will be covering in our next video. First, let us see how to print a triangle of stars. Then we will just modify the program in order to print triangle of numbers. First, we need to get this format correct. Here we have 5 lines of stars printed. Let us see how many stars are printed in each line. So when the line number is 1, number of stars printed is 1. When line number is 2, we have 2 stars printed. When line number is 3, we have 3 stars printed. In order to print this type of triangle, we will have to use a nested for loop in which first loop is going to keep track of the line number. Second loop is going to keep track of the number of stars that is printed in each line. So now let's write the code for this. Here I'll write for I equals to 1. I'm going to use variable I to keep track of the line number. I need 5 lines of input. I need 5 lines of stars, so I'll write I less than equal to 5, I plus plus. Now for every line, what needs to be done? We need to print that many stars in every line. So I will start J from 1. How many times this loop should get executed? I number of times. That is, when I is equal to 1, it is line number 1, and J should execute 1 time. When I is 2, it is line number 2, and J should execute 2 times, meaning it should print 2 stars. Therefore, J is less than equal to I and J plus plus. Here, for every value of J that meets this condition, we are going to print a star. After printing all the stars in one particular line, so before we go to change the value of I, that is before we proceed to the modification part of the outer loop, we first go to the next line. So outside this inner for loop, we have to write the code to go to the next line. Here variable I is going to keep track of the line number, and inner loop is going to keep track of number of stars per line. Now this loop is going to execute 5 times, meaning it is going to print 5 triangles because we have considered I less than equal to 5. Suppose I want to print the same triangle n number of times. So the user is going to give the input how many lines of stars are required. Based on that, the program output should modify. In that case, we just use a variable n, and value for this n must be accepted as an user input before we start this for loop. This is to print a triangle of stars. Now in the same pattern, instead of stars, if I have to print numbers like this, so I am going to print a pattern of this format. So now what we have to do is, we are not going to print stars. Instead, we will print some values. So what are we going to print? An integer value, right? So we have to write printf percentage d. And which value are we supposed to print? If you observe, value of I is 1 for the first loop. Value of I is 2 for printing second line. And value of I is 3 throughout this third line. What keeps changing is J. J starts from 1 up to I. Every time the inner loop is executed, it is restarting its value from 1 until I. Therefore, by printing J, we will get this output. Now exactly same pattern, suppose we want to display repeated numbers, that is if line number needs to be repeated like this. Now if you observe, what is printed is actually the line number. Line number itself is printed that many number of times. So line number is actually present in variable I. Just replacing J with I gives us this triangular output. So now let us write the complete program for this. And let us check the output for all these 3 triangular formats. As always, we will start our program by commenting the objective of the program. Here we are going to print triangular patterns. We need to include stdio.h file in all our programs. Now I'll write the main function. I need I and j to use it as looping variables, and I am going to use variable n because I will take the user input. Based on the user's preference, the number of lines is printed in the triangle. Whatever value the user enters is stored in the variable n using scanf statement. I told in the previous video also, don't forget to give this ampersand symbol, without which you will not get any error. But the value that you are going to give is not going to be stored in the variable n, it is stored randomly elsewhere. Now let us write the loop for printing stars. I equals to 1, I less than equal to n, I plus plus. And the inner loop is, for j equals to 1, we need to start j from 1, and j is up to I, up to the line number. We need to print a star. And before we modify the value of I, we will have to go to the next line. Let us save the program, and don't forget to give .c extension, without which it is going to be considered as a C++ program. Now compile the program. In case you have any errors, it will be displayed here at the bottom of the window. No errors, errors, warnings is all zero. So now we will execute our program. Enter the value of n. I am going to enter 7, and I have got a triangle with 7 lines full of stars. Now I have got a triangular pattern of stars with 7 lines. I'll execute the program again. I'll give just 3. I have a very small triangle of 3 lines. Now the same program, let us modify to get that numerical triangular pattern. So as we discussed already, we are going to print numbers. Which number? If I print j, every time you modify the program, don't forget to save the program, compile it again, and then run. So here I'll give 5. When I give 5, I have got a triangular output with 5 lines. Every line, the numbering is starting from 1. Now I will change this j to I, and just this one small change is going to give me a different output. So I'll give 5 again. It prints whatever is the line number that is printed that many number of times. Hope you understood the video. In case you have any clarifications with the logic of the program, you can comment it. If you want us to solve any specific algorithm, be it anything related to data structures or sorting, linked lists, whatever it is, you can mention that in the comment section. We will definitely create a video within 3-4 days. Thanks for watching. Like this video. If you have any comments, if you have any suggestions or thoughts, mention in the comments, and also share this video among your contacts. See you in the next video. Until then, bye bye.